If you go to the diving board on this map and jump on the diving board, you can actually jump pretty high. And I can't wait so we can break apart the if I seem a little unimpressed with this an antisocial pessimist, but usually I don't. What's going on, guys? Drive here. I got a brand new video here today, and welcome to Black Ops Cold War. Finally, the game's out, and for today's video, I just wanted to make a short video going over some Cold War secrets that some of you may not know about. So without any further ado, let's get right into the video here. And really quick, before we get into the secrets here, I just wanted to apologize if you already know some of these secrets that I'm about to show off. I feel like most of these secrets are mainly for the newer players, so if you're more of an advanced player, you probably will know most of these secrets. But like I said, I do apologize if you already know some of these. So anyways, let's get right into it. So for the first secret that I wanted to go over, I just wanted to point out that this game, if you shoot and reload while aiming in, it's just like Modern Warfare. You can do that in this game, which is pretty nice. Another feature, if you don't know about, if you press up the scoreboard and hit your right bumper, or I'm not sure what button it is, but it tells you on the top of your screen, you can look at the map, move around, you can actually shoot and do all sorts of stuff. This is your map view, because in other CODs you would just have to hit the start button and then you would see the map, but for this game you can just press the scoreboard or the map button right here, as you can see. I also wanted to point out, for the first time ever, there is markings in multiplayer. Kind of similar to Warzone, all you have to do is press left on the D-pad. You can set a waypoint for your team and your entire team can see it. Now if you press the D-pad twice, the same button twice, you can mark as a danger. So that is very useful for public matches for people who don't have a mic. And it also works in zombies too. Also with the waypoints, you can actually, as soon as you mark something, you can just delete it by looking at the same one. You know, delete it, which is pretty cool. And I also wanted to point out, there is gestures in this game. As you can see, if you hold left on the D-pad, you can choose any of these gestures, as you can see right here. So that's pretty cool. And then there is a inspecting weapon feature in the gestures. You just have to select it and boom, you can inspect your weapon. And this game is very similar to Black Ops 4 in the fact that you can actually slide left, right, and backwards. All you have to do is just jump, or actually you can just like just run in place. Well, not run in place. You can just run and then jump and then slide, if I can do it correctly. Hold on. Yeah, just like that. So you gotta like run, look right, and then slide. So we try it here on the left, you just look, wait, you gotta get it at the right spot here. So you look left, boom, you can slide. And if you want to do it backwards, you can just boom. It's kind of hard to do. There you go, just slide backwards. So you just run, look backwards while you jump, and then boom. And there's these ammo crates on the map. This is the first time I've ever seen a COD do this. That they, on like, I'm pretty sure on every single map they have ammo resupply, which is pretty nice. That's a really cool feature that they have. I just wanted to point out that you can slide off anything, even off here. It's much more easier if you do it this way. And just in case if you're not aware already, this game has a lot of setting features. As you can see, we have your controller, your normal controller stuff here. We got a bunch of different settings for it. You got like auto sprint, auto move forward. I'm not gonna turn this on until Warzone comes out. I might turn this on like sprint behavior. So as you can see, you can mess with a bunch of these. I recommend looking. Actually, I'm gonna disable the parachute auto deploy. I don't really like that. But you can mess with these settings in your game. There's so many in the graphics settings. I have my field of view up to 120. I've been messing around with like 120, 110. I'm just trying 120 for now. Audio, this is the normal audio stuff. And then interface is pretty cool, because you can actually turn off like hit markers or crosshairs, or so it's like really cool. Player names, like so much stuff you can take off and put on. I definitely recommend you go over it. This is CODcaster. This is not really, there's no point in showing this off. This is for the CODcasters. Okay, we're almost out of time. No, we're not out of time. No, I wanted to show off something. Oh god, I don't know if we're gonna make it. Okay, well, as we're making our way to the diving board, I just wanted to point out, just in case if you didn't know about this map already, if you go to the diving board on this map and jump on the diving board, you can actually jump pretty high, as you can see. It's pretty nice. Here's another thing I wanted to point out. Just like Modern Warfare, you can actually jump atop of a vehicle. Alright, let me try jumping on these vehicles, because I want to show you guys that you can actually do that. Oh god, I'm the VIP. Oh god, well, this is the example. I'm not dying. Oh god. Another thing that I wanted to point out is, if you look on the mini map is back, not like Modern Warfare. The minimap is finally back to normal, where if someone shoots, they pop up on the minimap. I wanted to point this out too, if you go to change class, you can actually edit your class just like Modern Warfare, so that's also a nice feature. Well guys, that's gonna be it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm still working on this microphone settings to see if it sounds good, and I'm also working out the game settings to see if it's loud enough and all that jazz. I need to adjust some things before the next couple videos, so probably the next couple Cold War videos that you see from me are probably just going to be a little bit of a work in progress. It might be, each video might be a little bit different from each other, but hopefully they're good enough for you guys. So just need to work on some things, and everything should be good to go before the series starts in around season one, whenever that drops. I do apologize once again if you already know some of the things that I showed off in this video. Yeah, I'm done rambling on, that's it. So thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out, everyone. Oh. Hi there, chicken. What are you doing? Looks like you're trapped in there. Sorry. Oh my god. Oh god, I did not mean to do that. Oh god. What the heck was that noise? There's another one? Oh my god, you're everywhere.